Okay, so very good morning to one and all. Am I audible to you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. Okay. Anyway, right. A very good morning to one and all once again. Right. So in the last class, Amma, we already started and we continuously learning the step-by-step processes of your gate drives. So in the last class also we discussed about the loading conditions. See, before we discussing the actual design process of individual gates, first we have to understand some basic points. What are those basic points? If you understand those basic points, then it is easy for you to design any gate drive. So normally, we generally learn the design process of gate drives. Right now, right? Now here onwards, we try to discuss the each and every design process of gate drives individually. That means per gates and helical gates. Okay? Now what are the basic points to try to understand while you are designing of any gate drive? Right. The first and foremost thing, Amma, very, very, very important point is, first you try to decide the weakest part on your design. That is a very, very important point. Please pay attention and try to understand what I am explaining. Then it is easy for you in your designing process as well as while you are, especially these things are useful in your problem also, especially. Not only in design, while you are solving the problem, these steps are very, very useful one. The first and foremost thing is, first you have to try to understand the what is the weakest part. What is the weakest part on your design? I mean, on your design component. That means here you are having gear and pinion, right? So gear and pinion are the two components we are having, and you try to decide which part is the weakest part. So on that particular part only you have to concentrate. On that particular part only. Suppose while you are calculating, you got the result of pinion is the weakest part. Among gear and pinion, pinion is the weakest part. If at all pinion is the weakest part, then you have to concentrate only on pinion. Then you have to concentrate only on pinion. So where you supposed to calculate this is the weakest part? How do you calculate means? Based on the material. Type of material. First one is type of material. Here type of materials plays a very, very important role. Normally, especially in case of in your textbook point of view, I'm talking about in your textbook point of view, in your design point of view, at low level, in the intermediate level, we can say that the intermediate level, here we are using only same material. Here we are using same. Normally we are having only same material for both the pinion and gear. Normally we are experiencing, but in actual practice, you can use different types of material for both pinion for pinion and gear. That means. Suppose if you are supposed to use for cast iron for gear and another metal used for pinion, there is no problem. There is no problem, right? So that is the case. So it depends upon the purely type of the material, and based on the type of material and type of the material properties, you try to estimate which part is the weakest part, whether it is pinion or gear, and you have to consider that weakest part. You have to consider that weakest part may be pinion or gear, whatever it is. And whenever you are having a same material, whenever you are having a same material, blindly you can go that pinion is the weakest part. So this is the basic you have to understand. And it purely depends upon the, already you are having a relation, tooth form factor. You are having a tooth form factor, right? Tooth form factor, one tooth form factor is Y value. So we are having some standard relation of your Y value. Those Y value plays a very, very important role here while you are estimating the weakest part of your pinion and gear. So this procedure is common for whether you are using for spur gear or helical gear. This part is this procedure is common. The first and foremost point while you are designing any gate drive, first you try to estimate the weakest part. You try to estimate the weakest part, right? If it is a similar material, then pinion is the weakest part, and if it is a two different materials, then automatically you can say that by calculating. So you are having some calculation part. By making the calculation, you can say that which one is the weakest part. By analyzing the result, you can say that it may be gear, it may be pinion. Next. So after estimating of the weakest, because already you know that what is the weakest part. So after estimating the weakest part, then you can estimate the number of teeth. Number of teeth on gear or pinion, whatever it is. You can estimate the number of teeth. That is the second important point. Number of teeth. And I already told you that in the previous classes, you try to recollect that the minimum number of teeth, while you are calculating the number of teeth, minimum number of teeth, I try to show one table. I try to show one table. On the particular table, you are having, based on your standard gate tooth system, 14.5 degrees and 20 degrees full depth inval system and 20 degrees stub inval system, you are having some value sum. 18, 14, 20, 22, likewise, you are having some standard values, right? So I already showed the table. So you please go back your previous topics what I've discussed, and on that case you are available. So according to that standard gate tooth system, because standard gate tooth systems are specified. If at all, if it is not specified, and here another important point is, each and every case you try to specify the standard gate tooth system. It may be 14.5 degrees, it may be 20 degrees. Normally or frequently we are using 20 degrees full depth involute system. This is another important point. If at all, if it is not specified in your design or in your problem, especially this case is occurred while you're solving the problem. 20, if at all, if it is not mentioned, the standard gate tooth system, then you try to assume that it is a 20 degrees full depth involute system and the number of teeth on pinion is 18. So you need not remember, this is available in your table, right? Just for the reference only, I am saying. Just for your reference only, I am mentioning it, right? So the standard, you have to remember, and I mean, you have to keep this point in your mind. Keep this point in your mind, right? So standard gate tooth system is important. And the second point is, based on your standard gate system, you try to estimate number of teeth on pinion or gate. So you need to choose one standard number of teeth. It may be gear, it may be pinion. Once if you know the number of teeth and pinion, and you calculate number of teeth and pinion easily, if it requires, right? So the best example is, suppose while you are calculating, suppose in the given data, they mention that number of teeth and pinion. Number of teeth and pinion is 18. But the problem belongs to different material. That means pinion is made with one material and gear is made with another material. And while you are calculating, gear is the weakest part. While you are calculating, the result show that gear is the weakest part, right? If that is the case, in your given data, number of teeth and pin is mentioned, but what about the number of teeth and gear? Then you can easily calculate it by using the relation. On that particular case, these are useful one. So that is the reason why I'm saying that first thing is you try to estimate which one is the weakest part. After estimating the weakest part, you try to estimate the number of teeth on pinion or gear. On pinion or gear. Right? Then afterwards, after calculating of your number of teeth are over. Right? And you know the standard gate tooth system. That part is also over. And you already know that weakest part. That part is also over. Next, you try to calculate the module value based on the standard relation. Module value. So module value is very, very important. You try to calculate. The module value based on the relation. Module value means simply, in order to calculate the module value, some basic important parameters are required. That is tooth form factors and velocity value and phase width value, and all these terminologies are required. So by considering the data or by referring the data, whatever it is, whatever the manner, so simply can calculate the module value. Once if you know the module value, then you can calculate the standard parameters of your gate drive. What are the standard parameters? Simply saying that once if you calculate the module value, then you can able to calculate what is the diameter of the pinion and diameter of the gear. And if at all, if any other data required, if at all, if you require center distance, you can calculate. If at all, if you require circular pitch value, you can calculate. Likewise, whatever the data, because we already discussed that some of the important terminology in your gate. So on the particular gate, whatever the terminology that is available, all those terminology you can calculate at the initial level of your this particular design procedure. So once if you came across of your all the required parameters, then only you try to estimate whether these dimensions are sustained for given loading conditions. Right? Directly you cannot calculate the loading, that means static loading conditions or dynamic loading conditions or all those things. Right, so this is a step-by-step procedure and step-by-step approach. Once if you completed all the steps, then only you can go for beam strength value. Right, once if you know the beam strength, I told you that beam strength is a very, very important consideration. Based on the beam strength only, you can able to to judge whether the design is safe or not by comparing with your other loading conditions like static loading condition, dynamic loading condition, loading conditions. Right? So the beam strength value should be high compared that of your remaining values. Then only the design parameters, what you decided or what you derived in the earlier stage, that is your number of teeth and module value, face width value, and diameter of the pitch, and diameter of the gear and diameter of the pinion. So all these parameters are true. Otherwise, you have to remodify. Otherwise, we have to remodify. Right? So this is the general steps normally we came across while you were designing of your any gate drive. And not specifically mentioned that spur gear, helical, spur gears are helical gears, but this design procedure is common for each and every gate. While you are, if you want to design for any gate drive, you have to follow these steps. So you please be remember the steps I have explained, so that is easy for you while you are calculating. I mean, while you are solving the problems, especially these things are very, very useful ones. Definitely, at one particular point of time, each and every student we are having a doubt. Definitely. So they feel difficulty, or they may feel that means there is no path for solving of the problems if you are not understanding of this concept thoroughly or step by, right? So my sincere request is, whatever the problem it is mentioned in your examination or while you are practicing, just simply observe my instruction or simply follow my instructions as easily, then it is easy for you. Definitely, while I am solving the problems also, I carefully explain the step-by-step procedure. You need not worry. Again, on particular case also, I try to explain step-by-step procedure. But meanwhile, please, because we try to learn the design procedure, so that it is very important for you to understand. So what the actual thing is going on your this particular gate dress, spur gate dress or helical gate dress, right? So this is very, 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 very important approach. Very, very important concept. Very, very, very important concept. Right? Right. Now we try to go for the each and every. Now we try to discuss about the each and every. Right. Now try to design the each and every parameter of your what we call the gate drives. So now we try to discuss about this spur gear. Okay. Right. So as I showed the design procedure of spur gear, this is very, very important question. In the examination, out of your 4 sets, in 1 set, definitely they try to ask for the design procedure of any one gear. They try to ask for the any one gear. If you know the design procedure, your entire problem is very easy. Very easy. Right. First one, step one. You can say that it is a step one. So in step one, so first of all, the design. All the design tangential load is obtained from the power transmitted and the pitch line velocity by using the following relations. So first we try to calculate the tangential load. You already know that we are having two types of loading condition, WT and WR. So WR causes the compressive loading condition and WT causes the bending loading condition, bending stress. You can say that it is a bending stress. WT causes the bending stress. So you can able to calculate by using this relation, WT equal to P by V into CS, where CS is called as the service factor. Now you can read down the terminology. So the terminology here is WT is the permissible tangential tooth load. And again here, the units are very, very important. So WT is the load condition that is acting in tangential direction, and P is the power transmitted. So P is the power transmitted, right, in terms of watts. Normally we are using in kilowatts, but no problem, some textbooks they are mentioning in terms of watts. And one more thing, amma, whatever the units here some of the textbooks are they are using kilowatts, some of the textbooks they are using watts, amma, but you try to learn the standard design procedure, right? Please don't, and here please don't get confused. Again and again I am saying that you please don't get confused, and you just simply follow the procedure, what are the available in your textbooks, and follow the units as easily. Don't try to convert as per your convenience. Because suppose here it is your watts, please don't try to convert into kilowatts. Or if it is in kilowatts, don't try to convert into watt. I mean, simply you try to convert into watts if you are using the units are in watts. So I hope you are understanding what I am saying. That my simple suggestion is, please try to follow the units as easily in your design procedure, because these relations are useful for that particular terminologies only. They will give the satisfied results, right? So that is the reason why I'm keep on stressing. Otherwise, there is no problem if you convert into in terms of mm's or meters. There is no problem. But here we strictly follow the units. We strictly follow the units. Right. So V is the pitch line velocity. So V is the pitch line velocity in terms of meter per second, and the formula for pitch line velocity is pi d n by 60. Pi d n by 60. Right. So, and d is the pitch circle diameter. D is the pitch circle diameter. So pitch circle diameter in terms of meters, right? Pitch circle diameter in terms of meters. So here you can say here we are using one standard relation. You know the circular pitch value. What is the circular pitch value formula? Pc equal to pi into d by t, or pi d by t. Simply you can say that, right? So while you are calculating module, module formula is simply you are having d by t. So d by t means here diameter and teeth. Diameter and teeth. It may be pinion, it may be gear, whatever it is, no problem. It may be pinion, it may be gear, no problem. But module value is d by t, right? So now you are having diameter value can be calculated as m into t. So these relations are useful, especially please be paying attention and please be concentrated on the relations what I am explaining here. I am reading here. Why I am saying that means simply these relations especially useful one whenever you are having a difficult problem. Especially suppose if I directly know the pitch circle diameter, right, diameter, I mean a pitch circle diameter, then there is no problem. You can directly substitute in the given relation. But if at all there is any terminology regarding of your with respect to teeth or with respect to m values, and it is very very difficult for you to solve the relation, right? If you forget the formula, then it is very very difficult for you. You can substitute only if they provide direct value. If not, definitely it is not possible for you. On that particular case, this relation is very very useful one. So please go through the terminologies of your gate drives. Gate drives especially, because random, dedendum, and circular pitch value, module value, right? You are having different terminologies that are available in your gate drive. You please go and standard distance likewise. You please go through the terminology step by step, one by one, and try to note down the relations. And those relations are very very helpful while was especially for solving the problems. Most I already observed, many number of students are. Service factor, I already explained the service factor, CS value, service factor, and the service factor value are having standard values, no problem. Service factor means there is no formula, you don't worry. Service factor has standard value, maybe the values vary from 1 to 2, depending upon the conditions. Normally, the value will be varying from 1 to 2 only, service factor value. Okay, no problem. But here, please understand that the relation is very, very important. And I regularly observing the student that when they provide the data, they can easily substitute in the relation. And if at all there is a if there is any twist in the problem, simply they leave the problem in the examination. They are leaving the problem in the examination. Please don't do that, Amma. You strictly blindly follow the design procedure as easily what are the available in your textbook, right? And try to learn the equations or what we called or any formulas you are having. You try to remember means simply it is available in data book. If it like this equation, circular pitch value or any other relations, you please tick a mark on your data book. There is nothing wrong. right? You first try to substitute step-by-step approaches, then it is easy for you for solving the problem. Otherwise, definitely, if at all, if you are not doing any work, then definitely each and every student will experience a difficulty in the examination. Nobody is an exception for those things. Right? So you're having a relation, WT equal to P by V into CS. So once P value is known, V value is known, then it is easy for you. If it has direct values, if it is unknown values, or if the values are not directly mentioned, you try to solve from the equations. V means pi d by 60, velocity. So whether V value is known or N value is known, you please refer from your data. Right? So if at all, if it is not there, then try to go for another relation. If there is any other relations are available, you try to check one by one. That is the main motto of this equation. It is not simply like that using of equation directly, because this equation is available in your data book. But you try to learn the terminology or notation that are used in the equation. P value, V value, and CS value, you don't worry. CS value, service factor, you don't worry. But P value and V values. Right? So this is very, very important. So where M is called as the module and T is the number of teeth, and you don't worry whether number of teeth are opinion and gate, depends on, it depends upon the problem. Whether you're supposed to use for number of teeth for pinion or number of teeth on gate, you try, don't try to use both number of gate teeth. You try to use only one teeth, especially whether it is for pinion or gate. Right? That is very, very important. Next. So I have told you that CS is the service factor and N is the speed. Please observe that N is the speed in RPM and CS is the service factor. For service factor, for steady loading condition, and you are having 0.8 normal, I have told you that you are having the value range from 1 to 2. Please remember that value, no problem. Whether it is a heavy load or medium shock load, or you don't bother, Amma, because 1.5 and 2, there is no drastic change in your answer. If at all, if you're having any difficulty, or if at all you're finding difficulty for finding the values in your data book, especially for CS value, no problem. The value always is vary from 1 to 2. Standard value, 1 to 2. Right? Right. So it is for the table, and according to the table, you can take the value of CS. CS is the service factor. Right? Right. Next, apply the Lewis equation. This is another important one. So apply the Lewis equation. So before that, Amma, apply the Lewis equation means Lewis equation nothing but your beam strength equation. So before you are using the beam strength equation, I already explained some basic steps in the beginning of the class. Right, the beginning of the class, I already explained some important points. First, you try to calculate the weakest part. Second, you try to estimate the number of teeth. Third one is you try to calculate the module value. Then you try to calculate the remaining what we call terminologies. After completion of all those things, only you can go for the Lewis equation. After completion of all those procedures, then only you can go for the Lewis equation. It is very, very important. Right. So simply, the formula for Lewis equation is already. We are having WT equal to sigma W into B into PC into Y. So what is meant by PC and all those things? Simply you can simplify the equation. Sigma naught into CV into B into pi into M into Y. Where Y is the tooth form factor. Y is a tooth form factor, M is a module, and B is a fixed width, and the sigma naught is a static loading condition. Already you know that. Already we cover all these things. Right? So this is very, very, very important, Amma, here again in this equation. First you try to observe the equation and terminology, then we can go for the terminology. So here beam strength equation means sigma naught into no option, Amma. We can at least try to develop for another textbook or another data book, right? You try to, because I tried very much on the internet, Amma, because I didn't find any free versions especially, right? Still I am searching. If at all, if there is any available, then definitely I try to. But meanwhile, see, it is not meant for, suppose if I am supplied one data book, Amma, suppose let us say one McGraw-Hill version or some other version data book. So most of the students are fixed for those McGraw-Hill, because in your mind those terminals are only available in your mind. But if at all in your examination, because data books are available in your examination, if at all instead of McGraw-Hill you provided some other test book, so what you supposed to do? That is my I'm very much worried about regarding of your data book, amma, because each and every data, because in data book the everywhere the answers are same and equations are same, but the notations are different. The notations are different. In some other textbook they are using, here we are using WT. In some other textbook they are using sigma. Right? So you strictly fix in your mind WT value is fixed for your what we call beam strength value. But in your given data book, the WT notations are not available. Right? So it is very, very difficult part on that particular situation. So that is the reason why I'm keep on saying that you please purchase your data book. Otherwise, at least you try to rent for a data book on your own. Then it is easy for you while I'm explaining here, while you are referring of your data book, if there is any change in terminology, please write down on that particular case. Sigma, WT, both are same. And M and some other values, both are same. Likewise. Right? So that is the reason why I'm keep on saying that please be having a data book. Your own data book. So at least after having this, by November 2, so I hope everyone is having an internal examination or something like that. So you please visit, while you are coming to the college, definitely you are having your books in library. So maybe your problem will solve. I hope that your problem will solve. Right. So if there is no possibility, means simply you have to purchase your data book. There is no other option. There is no other option. Each and every person should purchase their own data book. There is no specific other, means I already specified the other. If you want, you can go for other, the particular other. Otherwise, the available test book you can purchase, no problem. But the intention is here, you please go through the data book and verify the terminology. That is important. Verify the terminology. Right? So textbook to textbook, the terminologies are varied. Please understand that. So many of the students get difficulty by identifying the terms, especially while you are having the regular classes. And the last time, most of the students feel, they get confused, amma, by identifying the terminology. That is my fear of, especially there is no fear in problem solving, but especially identifying the values is a major cause of fear for me, especially in your point of view. Right? So anyway, so in applying the Lewis equation, amma, you should please understand the term Lewis equation. So Lewis equation means here you are using a terminology of WT and sigma W B into PC into 1. So B is the face width. I already mentioned that B is the face width. If at all the face width is not mentioned, and generally you can consider the face width value as 10 times module. Normally we can consider face width value as B value as 10 times module. So if you know the module value, then you can substitute 10 times module easily, and you can get the value of face width. So B value equal to 10 times module. This is a fixed one. Please remember. Right? And M is the module value, and Y is the tooth form factor. The tooth form factor for pinion or gear, it is a different one. Amma. Depends upon your problem. Y value is called as the tooth form factor or Lewis form factor. So Lewis form factor value will be depends upon for depending upon the problem. Right? So instead of Y, we are having YP or YG. YP means tooth form factor for pinion. YG means tooth form factor for gear. So where what part you can consider means it will be depending upon the problem and upon the weakest part. Right? Next, we are having noted points here. You please understand the noted points. The Lewis equation is applied only to the weaker of the two wheels. This is very, see, I'm keep on saying that this point at the beginning of the class. Whenever you are having a same material, always pinion is the weakest part. Whenever you are having a two different materials, then you try to calculate. After calculation and after analyzing, you try to understand what is the weakest part, and based on the weakest part, you try to apply the Lewis equation. That means this Lewis equation is applied for the weakest part. Ah, okay, we came. The first step we came to know. You don't worry. Simply, don't forget the value of Lewis. You don't worry. I will explain. No problem. Okay. So, so CV value. Okay, CV value means here. You already based on your velocity. So somebody on your mic, please put on your mic. Right. So CV value. CV value means already we explained that CV value will be depends upon the velocity. Velocity, based on your velocity. So based on your velocity. Velocity means. Less than 10 meter per second and 12.5 meter per second, 15 meter per second. So number 40, I'll tell you that please put off your mic. Right. So CV value already we discussed that purely depends upon the velocity. So whether your velocity is less than 10 meter per second or more than 20 meter per second, we are having some values 3 by 3 plus v, 6 by 6 plus v, and 7.5 by 7.5 plus root v. So we already discussed that value based on your velocities. CV value you have to consider. CV value you have to consider based on your velocity. Okay, right. So I hope you cleared that doubt, Amma. Already, you please go back to your values. On the particular case, I already explained how you consider the CV value purely based on your velocities. The velocity value is less than 10 meter per second to more than 20 meter per second. The values will vary. Okay. Okay. Fine. Right, is there any other terminology you will miss some or no? So I hope already I covered almost all the terminology. So sigma naught is the static loading condition and C value is the velocity factors. B is the phase fit and M is the module and Y is the tooth form factor. Next. The Lewis equation is applied for the only weaker section, that is pinion or gear, whatever it is. Next. Next. It is an important point. When both the pinion and gear are made of the same material, then pinion is the weakest part. This point is already explained. Right? In the beginning of the class, I already told you that whenever you are having both pinion and gear are made with the same material, pinion is the weakest part. Right? Now, when the pinion and gear are made with the different materials, when pinion and gear are made with the different materials, then the product of sigma W into Y or sigma naught into Y, right, is the deciding factor. That is the product of these two values, sigma naught into Y value or sigma W into Y value, will decide which one is the weakest one. Right? So you calculate the value of sigma naught into V Y and you calculate the sigma naught into Y for gear and sigma naught into Y for pinion. Then by analyzing of those two values, you can estimate that which one is the weakest part. By analyzing of those terminology, you can easily estimate that which one is the weakest part. Right? So it is very, very important, and this point is to be done at the beginning of the design. At the beginning of the design, you have to write a statement. You have to write a statement by understanding the data of your question. If it is made with the same material, both pinion and gear made with same material, then blindly you can write that pinion is the weakest part. Pinion is the weakest part. Right, right. Yes, 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 Amma. Yes, yes, yes. If it is available in your problem, there is no worries. If at all it is not available, if there is any twist in the question, directly you can apply the one third of ultimate tensile strength. Yes, that is correct. Right. So when both pinion or gear, in the beginning of the class, in the beginning of the problem, while you are understanding the particular problem, first the statement is we have to write that which one is the weakest part. So if it is the same material, pinion is the weakest part. If it is a different material, you try to calculate the product of sigma naught into Y for both pinion and gear. All right. So by analyzing the result, you can say that whether gate is the weakest part or pinion is the weakest part. After deciding that particular part, then only you can move for the remaining parts or remaining steps. So this step is to be done at the beginning of your design. Please be understand. So especially when the next class, while you are solving the problem, again if I am asking the question, you please respond. Your answer must be like this only. And you have to write the statement on your examination also. This carries 1 or 2 marks especially. Without knowing the weakest part, you are not supposed to proceed your design procedure. You are not supposed to, because which part you are doing, whether pinion are doing or pinion part or gear part you are doing your design procedure, you have to mention. Otherwise, there is no meaning of your design procedure of your gate drives especially. Right? Okay, fine. So this is how you supposed to calculate. I hope you understand this up to this point, Amma. So especially this step is very, very important step. This step is very, 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 very important. Right? Okay, fine. Next. So we see from the Lewis equation that for the pair of mating gear, the quantities like WT, B, M, and CV are the constant, and sigma B and Y is the only deciding factor. So you not worry about this thing, Amma. Normally we are applying, we are using the terms of B, M, and M and C values, but only that means in the equation part, Y only we are using sigma naught into Y. Here he is giving an explanation, right? Right. So please keep in your mind sigma naught into Y or sigma W into Y is the deciding factor. Right, fine. Next. So here he is mentioned that the face width. So the product of sigma W into Y is called a strength factor. So you can say that what is the strength factor for 2 mark question or 1 mark question you are having. What is the strength factor means sigma W into Y is called as a strength factor. Okay, fine. Now the face width. So I already explained that what is the face width. So normally you don't worry about all these values. Normally the value will be taken as 3 PC to 4 PC or 9.5 M to 12.5 M. For cut teeth and 2 PC to 3 PC for cast teeth. So you not worry about all these things. Simply remember 10 times module. That is sufficient. Maybe in your questions, some of them may vary. But if you're able to recognize this value, it is fine. Otherwise, simply blindly remember that B value equal to 10 times module. That is sufficient. No need to go for 3 PC to 4 PC or some 6.5 M, M to 9.5 M. No need. No need to remember all those things. Just simply remember 10 times module, that is sufficient. B value equal to 10 times module. Right? If at all, if you remember or if you can able to identify, no problem. You can apply. But those who are difficult difficult to identify, difficult to remember, just simply the B value is 10 times module, you simply remember. B value equal to 10 times module. Unless until if it is not specified, if it is specified, directly you can cancel those values. I am saying that if at all, if you require to calculate B value or if you try to assume the B value, directly calculate B value equal to 10 times module. Right? Right. Next. Afterwards, after calculation of your beam strength, you are having dynamic loading condition. So calculation of dynamic load on tooth gear by using Buckingham equation. So this equation is called as the Buckingham equation. So you know the formula WD equal to WT plus WI. WI is called as incremental loading condition. WI is called as the incremental loading condition. And increment load condition means 21 V into B into C plus WT by 21 V plus square root of B into C plus WT. So you already came across this result in your previous class. Right. Next. So here WT value is called as the PYV where P is in watts and V is the meter per second. Next. Static loading condition. Next, find the static tooth load. And the static tooth load is WS is equal to sigma E into B into EC into Y. Here it is the endurance strength. Sigma E is called as the endurance strength. Sigma E is called as the endurance strength. Right? And B is the face width and M is the module and Y is the Lewis form factor or gate tooth factor, whatever it is. So for safety against breakage, WS should be greater than WD. So for safety, so you should remember this value. Or this statement especially. You have to remember WS should be greater than WD. WS should be greater than WD. right? Next, finally, find the wear tooth. Wear tooth is dp into b into q into k. Right, the wear load should not be less than the dynamic load. So these two are very, very important. The dynamic load, I mean, the wear load should not be less than the dynamic load. So whenever we mention a statement, you have to note down the statement. Why? Because mean while you are checking, these statements are very, very useful for checking purpose, especially. That means whether your answer is right or wrong, based on this statement only you can verify. Because in a design, see, especially in a design procedure, there is no exact answer because each and every person takes some different values. Suppose if you are having a value of ranging from 1.5 to 3, some students take 1.5 value, some students consider 3 values, so automatically the answer is different. Even though the answer is different, you must satisfy this condition. You must satisfy this condition. That is the reason why they mention in each and every step. So in this case, the wear load should not be less than the dynamic load. Okay, the wear load should not be less than the dynamic load. So you please verify each and every statement. Or you are checking purpose for safety design purpose of your gate drive. Okay, try to understand, try to understand. These 5 steps are very, very important step while you're solving the problem, and try to solve within these 5 steps only. So please understand, Amma, if you thorough with these 5 steps. Thorough means simply all these steps are available in your data book already. No problem. And if it is available in data book, you blindly follow the design procedure as it is, that is available in data book. Right? So then it is very easy for you while you are solving the problem, especially how difficult it is. No problem. Whatever the difficult problem that mentioned in your examination, you can solve easily if you follow these steps thoroughly. Only these terminologies are occur. There is no other terminologies. Depending upon the type of data, suppose if you are having a center distance, even the center distance, you have to remember the center distance formula, because it is here, in these 5 steps, you are not having any center distance formula. Based on the center distance, you can use in this relation. Suppose the center distance formula is dp plus dg by 2, right? If at all the center distance value is given, then based on the center distance value, you can be able to calculate the dp value and dg value. On that particular purpose, you have to use. But these are the 5 steps, common steps for any problem. Common steps to any problem. Okay? So I hope you understand, Amma, this particular concept especially. 5 steps. So please go through these 5 steps and try to circulate the design procedure after having of this session. You please try to go for the design procedure. Right? So you please keep with your design procedure. In the next class, we try to solve the problem step by step. We try to solve the problem step by step. Then only you can easily understand. Right? So I already told you that. So the design procedures are, I mean, the design procedures are same, but the thing is the notations may vary from textbook to textbook. But in Bhandari, you are having some different technologies. Please observe after having the session. Right? So please stick on with one textbook, right? Then it is easy for you without confusion. Otherwise, definitely you will get confusion. Definitely. If you refer 2 or 3 textbook, then it is a clumsy one. Then definitely it is a clumsy one. Then it is very, very difficult for you to understand the design procedures. So stick on one textbook and try to follow the one textbook and one design data book also. Try to follow one design data book. Then your design is over. Right? It is very, very, very easiest thing. Okay, Amma. So I hope you understand and you try to be prepared with your next class with your design data books and your design procedure, Amma. Right? So thank you for your patience. And if you have any doubt, you please come up with your doubts for next class, Amma. No problem. There is no issue, or at least you try to post your doubts on my WhatsApp, Amma. Right? There is no issue. I try to solve. I already mentioned that if you have any problem while you are solving the problem, if you have any difficulty, you try to make a screenshot and send your problems to my WhatsApp. So nobody send, and I hope you are having no doubts. Right? So if at all you are having a doubt, please feel free to ask your doubts, Amma. Okay? So B and C are the constant values, Amma, you have here. C is the constant value, you already know that. You please refer your last equation, last class equation. On the particular case, we explained each and everything. You please verify. You please, it is not new equation we are using here. It is a not new equation. You please verify your previous, I mean, previous class already uploaded in your YouTube. You please verify. Or please refer your textbook, no problem. Okay? Right, fine. So thank you, Amma. Thank you for your patience. And thanks for your responses. And thanks for asking questions also. At least you are listening. That is the happiest part. Right. Okay. Thank you.